Namaste, good day to all my students. In this lecture, I will explain the second topic in module 3, the need for optimization, right? Before going for the need for optimization, in the last video, I explained the business case for IP. And the module name is also saying about the IP. Business case of IP with the 2 or 3 lines, I will recollect you so that you can clearly understand what is mean by optimization. What is IP? Because the question here it is raised is 30 years back we developed the IP. With that particular IP, we are communicating with the different devices in the internet. Can we use the same IP for communication between 2 devices in the Internet of Things? Already we say that it is impossible because IP is a very bulky protocol. And we have to optimize and we have to reduce it, and based upon our need, that amount of code we have to use. That is why it is explained 2 models here. One is adaptation model and another one is called it as adoption model. In the adaptation model, I told already existing one, we have to do some small changes. Which one we need, that one have to be implemented. That is adaptation model. There, in the adaptation model, one more concept will come here. That will come under the next topic only, but still I will explain so that you will understand here. That concept only it is explaining here. Here, always we will speak about the IP-based communication. That means in the internet, 98% communication is based upon IP. And one more communication method we will use as non-IP communication. There are different protocols we have. One or two protocols I will highlight here. One is called as Apple Talk. One is called as IPX. The full form of IPX is Inter Network Packet Exchange. Both the protocol which is communicating without the help of IP. That is why we will call it as a non-IP. But mostly in the IoT environment also, we want the IP-based communication. What we can do here is, non-IP have to be changed into IP-based. For that one, in between, we can use one device called as ALG. The full form of ALG, it is Application Layered Gateway. It is a device. Wherever the output is coming as a non-IP output, it have to be fed to a ALG device. And from that ALG device, it is going to convert into IP. Because in the IoT environment, most of the times we are talking that we want the IPv6. That's why this IP have to convert into IPv6 we are going to get. And what is mean by adoption model? Adaptation only I explain. Adaptation, one is small changes we can do it in the old IP and we can implement. Otherwise, non-IP also we can change it. That is also will come under adaptation only. One more is called as adoption model. In the adoption means we are making a new IP. We are not seeing about the old one or what are the problem. Mostly in the new IP means mostly we will go with IPv6 and we are going to implement in that particular constrained device. Because most of the times it is going to work on the constrained device. But non-constrained devices also can be come in IoT environment. Do not confuse that one. Always constrained. But maximum number of devices are constrained. That is the meaning. Now we will discuss our second topic, the need for optimization. The question is, IP is there, definitely we have to optimize, or we can go with old IP. The need, it is there or not? Yes, definitely the need is there. And we have to optimize the internet protocol suite. It is nothing but IP suite. Already the previous lecture also I explained here. Because IP suite means maybe in the IP and some other protocols also there to support the IP. That's why we will use the word as a suit, right? What is the challenges in IP in IoT solution? One is limits capacity. Definitely, one is challenges non-IP devices are there, still it is using an internet environment. That I told using this one ALGS, it's nothing but application layered gateway, we can solve it. One is that. Next one is device capacity is less, storage capacity is less, processing capacity is less. And in network level processing, it is less. Storage in network level processing is less. These are the total challenges for us to work with IP in the IoT environment. And optimizations are needed. Definitely it is not needed at various level of IP stack. That is why IP is a very bulk thing. Various level, lot of codes are there, and each code having its own working. Not even transferring of data. For transferring of data, lot of other things we want to transfer the data. That is why it is saying various levels we have to be handle the optimization. Then only we can use this is for the IoT environment. Here, both the nodes and network itself can offer be constrained in IoT solution. Already I told, already nodes. So nodes means devices are constrained only due to the low battery, low processing period. Even though network also it is constrained, already I told, it is unstable only. Because the devices it is constrained and the connectivity also it is unconstrained, or it is constrained, not unconstrained. It is constrained in nature. Why? Because it is unstable in nature, the connectivity. That is why both nodes as well as network in the IoTs is unstable as well as it is constrained in nature. That these all are challenging things for us to make the network. IP, and most of the time now what it is saying is, if you are taking India, we will use the version 4. Now, next thing is, we are converting from IPv4 to V6 also. That means the question is, we cannot able to make a protocol only for IPv6, because IPv4 also we are using here, and conversion also it is doing. And that is why most of the protocol have to be support for both. We cannot able to replace one. IPv4 I won't use. No. Because currently in so many network we are using IPv4. That's why we cannot able to replace completely. That's the meaning of this one. And again they are explaining about what is constrained node. A constrained node, different classes of devices are there. We do not have a single device. There are basically there are three classes of device that we are going to discuss in the upcoming slides. That's why constrained device, do not think that there is only one class. Based upon the processing power and all, it is divided into three classes, right? A thing may or may not offer similar characteristics compared to a generic PC or a server in the IT environment. Thing, because in the Internet of Things, the name itself, it is that thing. Thing cannot be like a PC. What is PC? Personal computer. Because what personal computer can do, everything cannot be able to do by a thing. Thing already we know that pen, pencil, desk, these all are thing. And each thing we are going to connect with the embedded chip. Then it is going to become a smart. We will make it as that particular thing as a smart. Do not think that that is the meaning of everything here, this meaning of this line. A particular thing is strong like a PC. No, it is very lightweight. It is light, battery power, everything it is there. Another limit is that network protocol stack on an IoT node may be required to communicate through an unreliable path. Already I told, the connectivity in an IoT environment, it is unreliable. That is the main thing here it is saying here. Even if a full IP stack is available on the node, for example, I already told full IP stack, that means what 30 years back we developed, same IP I am going to put into a constrained device. What are the problems I can face? That only it is highlighted here. Limited or unpredictable throughput. For example, I am sending 10 data from one system to other system. This is one system. This is other system through IoT environment I am sending. I send 10 messages. Maybe sometimes 10 messages will reach. Maybe 5 messages. Maybe 1 message. Maybe 0 message. I cannot able to predict it. But in a normal environment, in other than Internet of Things, most probably we can predict that minimum 5 messages is going to reach. Right? That prediction we can give, but here it is impossible because device is constrained and the connectivity is unreliable. That is why the meaning of unpredictable throughput. Throughput means how many data it is sending and how many it is reaching. And the low convergence when the topology changes. What is topology? We have different star, mesh, different topology. What the actual meaning here it is a new device, it is connected with the IoT network. Already in the IoT having 10 devices. Now 11th device came into that network, right? Just to think that 11th device currently came into that particular network. Now, due to the 11th device, every device should know that a new device came. For understanding these all the things, it will take a long time for that particular network than the normal network what we are using now. That is the meaning here. Once something changes or happen, understanding with everything, it will take a long time. Again, it is unreliable. These all are the matters. We will go to the next slide. Finally, power consumption. Yes, next, very important. Power consumption, because if you are putting the full IP stack, next important is power consumption, because battery power, it will consume more and the device is going to die very immediately. Because you already know, 10 lines, it will take some less battery power. 20 lines means it will take more battery power. 30 lines means it will take more. Full IP means maybe lakhs and crores of lines may be there. It will create the problem. One is topology changes are there. It was not able to do very immediately. And output, how many it is, data it is sending, how many it is reaching, that cannot able to predict. That is the second one. Third one, here it is battery power consumption. It is more. With the lifetime battery requirement may vary from, normally battery power, it may vary from few months to 10 plus year. Maybe in the IoT devices, we can able to get maximum is 10 plus years. But currently we have in some technology, Ethernet technology, it is wired LAN, what we are using in our lab. Next is Wi-Fi, already you know that in our college also we are using Wi-Fi. And cellular network, it is nothing but our mobile network. These all are not basically developed for IoT. This is basically developed for our currently internet environment, not for Internet of Things environment. If you are using this one, battery power is going to come down if you are using the same technology in Internet of Things. Which technology? Ethernet, Wi-Fi or cellular. Maybe the power it is going to less than a year. Less than a year only we can get. Otherwise, maybe you can get something like 10 plus year if you are using this technology, because this all the technology will keep taking the battery power. That's why it is going to become less than a year. That is why battery consumption will impact the communication, because more now, for example, a device is communication three times only. Device want to send a data three times, it will take less battery power. If we want to send five times, definitely it will take more battery power. That is why the meaning of this one. To help extend battery life, what we can do it? Because extend battery life means first the device have to be sleep. Why the device have to sleep? Whenever it want to send some data, at that time it is going to send. Otherwise, it won't use the battery power. It will go to a mode called as sleeping mode. That only it is explaining here. Always off. One question, I will read it. Describe the way in which IoT constraint nodes can be classified. That is a question I told. Already I told that answer. Three ways it can be divided. Constraint nodes can be divided into three ways. That is a question it is saying here. You can get a question maybe like this, so they can frame on some other way. Just based up while reading this one, I felt they can ask a question like that. That's why I put the question like this. Okay. There are mainly three types of devices. One, two, and next slide, one more is there. Three, right? I will go back. Yeah. Previous slides, I will go. One more. Yeah. See here. This one. Main important thing is device is there. That are the main things. Constrained only. Yes. Few bytes, very less number of data want to send. Very basically, if I am saying few bytes want to send, device it is constrained in nature. There, can I keep the adoption model, a new model, new IP? It's not required. What they are saying is you put an adoption model only. Previous IP 30 years back, you take whichever things you want, you take it from there, and you have to do some small changes, optimization have to do. That one, that IP you put it into that particular device. That is fine. That is why IP adaptation model you can use it here. What is the property of that device? Few bytes only can take. Few two bytes only can take means IP, complete IP we do not want to take. Which part you want, that part you take, do some small modification, optimization and put it into that particular device. That's the meaning of this one. And the next one, device having not few bytes, more bytes it want to send, but it did not like a computer. It is less than capacity of a computer. That is second one. More bytes want to transfer and capacity of that device is not exactly like a computer, what computer or laptop we are using. It is a little bit less than that particular one. There in that case, there are two types of IP will come. Non-IP also will come, IP also will come. That is the meaning of this one, right? There, in the case of IP base, definitely we can put an adoption model. Why? Because it is constrained device only, but it having little bit processing power. Because it is not reach up to a computer, but little bit less. But no problem. Because it can do something better than the first stage. First type of device. That's why definitely IP based thing, I can go with adoption model. I hope it's clear. I can go with adoption model. Non-IP also can become. Already I told, if it is non-IP, we cannot able to do the adoption model because that is a new model, new IP. We have to go with the adaptation model only. Adoption model we cannot able to go. Why? Non-IP means previous one concepts only. For that non-IP, maybe we want to make it as a IP in nature. Already we discussed in the first slide, ALGs can be used, application layered gateway. With the help of, we have to change it. There we cannot able to use the adaptation model, new IP model. It have to use adaptation model only, right? And here also it is saying, adaptation model between the gateway. Because your device it is there, 10 devices are there like that. Each device that data it is going to a gateway. From there it can be communicated. I hope already we discussed in the previous module. Already you know what is a gateway. That's why I'm not highlighted that one. Your device's data can be moved to a gateway. Device 10 devices it is here. Gateway is single gateway. Every data will go to the gateway. From the gateway it can go to whichever the place you want. Server or whichever the place it want. It is going to move. And the third one, this is like a PC only, there is no doubt. It is like a PC, third device. That is why somebody is asking in the IoT environment, always you can see a constrained device? No. Constrained device will be there and the device will also categorize into three, right? But always a more number of time constrained device, that is really true. Less byte transferring device will be there, there we will go with the adaption model. Second device is better than that, more data I want to transfer, but capacity is less than a PC. There are two methods we can implement. Adaptation I can implement, adoption I can implement. Adoption when I can implement is I want a complete IP only. Adaptation mode I can implement is there some non-IP will be there. Stack we will call. Do not compare with the stack. Stack is nothing but a set of program or something like that. Do not confuse with what is the name stack is using, right? And there we can go with adaptation model. And the third one, it is like a generic PC. It having strong processing power. Again, we can go with adoption model other than adaptation model. Because adaptation model, we cannot want to do for a strong device. Strong devices, normally we can go with adoption model. That is the thing it is explaining here. We can put the full IP. Right. The adoption model, we can put the full IP. There is no problem because it having its own strength to execute the things. Now, constrained devices only we studied. Three type of constrained device. Now, constrained network. Constrained devices are connected. Then network, it is constrained network. That is the meaning here. Here, in the early years, definitely some 10 or 20 years back, the network bandwidth is less and we are using the DSNL type of modem, low speed modem, that only it is explaining here to connect. There it is kilobytes per second only. Later now we can get a mega gigabytes per speed also, it is possibility, but mega definitely you are going to get it. That is, these two lines it is saying about our old internet. Network bandwidth is less, and low power modem we are going to use at that particular time, and the low speed connectivity demonstrated the IP could run over low bandwidth. But in the case of the IoT environment also, we do not want high speed, because this device cannot be push the data into the network with a high speed constraint device. I'm speaking about constraint, and other two devices are there. I'm not worrying about that one. We want, but this discussion I am worrying about the constraint device only, because they are clearly saying that it is constrained network. That's why. Fast forward to today, a evolution of networking has seen the emergence of now we can see high speed networks are there already. Just now I told. High-speed connections are not usable. Definitely, in the case of IoT, high-speed connections are not need that much high speed. Somewhat high speed is required. That much high speed, what we are going to use current internet, it is not required, because the device which is using also, it cannot able to maximize that particular bandwidth. If you are going with a low bandwidth, limited distance bandwidth due to the regulated traffic. Transmit power, because transmit power also will be less. Why? Because it's transmit power, if you are taking more battery, it is going to take more. These are the problems it is going to face. High latency, maybe a device, a data it is sending, it may having little bit more delay will be there compared with our normal data transferring and internet of things data transferring. And packet loss, number of packet it is going to lose, maybe high in Internet of Things due to the constrained in nature. Constrained networks have unique characteristics and requirement. That already I told. Each constrained network, because constrained node having its own property, that's why the network which is made up of constrained nodes have its own characteristics, its own properties are there. If you are thinking about our current internet, that's why typically IP network means current internet what we are using, it having fast link. But if you are thinking about the constrained network, that is IoT network, there can be wire or wireless network will be there, but it will be low power, low bandwidth, already we discussed. And it can transfer a few kilobits per second or few hundreds kilobits per second, and the devices are connecting with the star or mesh topology. These are the things for Internet of Things what it is explaining. Very few kilobits per second data, otherwise hundreds of kilobits, and they are connecting using star, mesh, or both combined topology we can use to connect the devices which is there in the Internet of Things. Next one is packet delivery rate. How many packet it is sending, how many packet it is receiving. It will be always oscillating between low and high percentage, because we cannot able to say that always high percentage, 10 it is sending, 10 it is reaching, high percentage, 100%, but we cannot able to say like that in the IoT environment. It can be sometimes low, it can be sometimes high, it can be sometimes in between also can be happen, because due to the constrained devices and the constrained network. Large burst of unpredictable errors, because unpredictable, we cannot able to predict that this many errors it's going to happen for the data, that can be happen in the constrained network. Next one example they are taking as power line communication may be having fluctuation of result can be. Power line communication is nothing but smart grid. We are connected the electricity with internet, that is power line communication. There the chance for error happening or fluctuation of delivery of data will be more, because we cannot able to say always, maybe sometimes all the data, sometimes half of the data, sometimes none of the data, that fluctuation may be more in power line communication. And next question, list and explain the major factors applicable to IPv4 and IPv6 support in IoT solutions. What are the major factors? Here already some of the things is basic things already you know. 20 plus years, that means previously we said 30 plus years only IP is made, mainly IPv4 and IPv6. One more IP is there, IPv5, we are not discussing here because it is used for the research purpose only. Mainly normally we will use either one, maybe we may use IPv4 or V6, that's why here it is discussing came through the support of IETF Internet Engineering Task Force. Already we discussed that is a standardization organization which is making the standards of IP. Right. What is the drawback of IPv4? Lack of address space. Most of the addresses, most of the IP we utilize or we used now, IPs are less. That's why we are going with the IPv6, because large number of address ranges we have for IPv6, right? Next, today both now can, next what here complete it is saying is, can we replace completely IPv4? It is impossible, because most of the network now itself we are going to use IPv4. That is why which of the new protocol are making for the Internet of Things, it should support both IPv4 plus IPv6. That is the thing it is explaining here. That is why it is unstretched, established, difficult to change. Already it is established IPv4, unstretched. That meaning is established, difficult to change. We cannot able to change immediately IPv4, right? We have using the conversion plus conversion from IPv4 to v6 tunneling, everything we are going to use, but we cannot able to replace completely, right? That is a thing it is saying here also. Different versions are there. We have, while it is implementing for the IoT, it should support IPv4 also, right? But which is better is IPv6 only. There is no doubt here. Technique I already told, conversion from IPv4 to v6 we may use for tunneling or translation. Translation means changing from IPv4 to v6, again can change back from IPv6 to v4. That are the methods we can use, translation as well as tunneling, right? This is conversion methods only, v4 to v6 or vice versa also. The following are the some of the major factors applicable to IPv4 and v6 support in IoT system. This is the correct answer you have to write for the previous question. What question I was given here, right? The correct answer it is from here. One is application protocol. You see here, Ethernet or Wi-Fi. It's nothing but Wi-Fi is nothing but wireless LAN, we can say. It is Ethernet is wired LAN. It can use both IPv4 and v6, right? But we already told we can use both, but it will support IPv4 and v6 also, both the protocol, but it may took more battery power. That's the problem for us IoT devices. These are the some of the protocols which is supporting only for IPv4. This protocol may be not going to support IPv6. One or some of the protocol, SCADA, supervisory control and data acquisition, such a protocol such as in that some of the protocol which is having SCADA, it is there in SCADA. Some of the protocol DNP3 bar IP, it is distributed network protocol, full form all it is saying. This sometimes we will call it as IEEE 1815. Next is Modbus. It is supporting TCP, that's why Modbus TCP or IEC 60870510 standards. These are all the standards which is supporting only for IPv4. Now, most of the times the vendors or the developers are trying to make it as IPv6. And these are the protocol which is supporting both. It is taken care by Internet Engineering Task Force. HTTP, already you know, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTPS, it is secure, COAP, already we discussed, Constrained Application Protocol, MQTT, Message Queuing Telemetry Transport, XMPP, Extensible Messaging and Presence Protocol. These all the protocols are supporting both IPv4 as well as v6. Next, first one we already discussed, it is application protocol. Next one is cellular provider and technology. It is cellular provider is cellular telephony. Previously we are using the cellular modems. If you are recollecting previously BSNL landlines only we had at that time. If you want the internet, you have to take the BSNL modems. They are going to, if you want in your home, they will come with the modem, they are connecting. It is speed also very less for us at that time, KBPS only. That only it is explained here. Cellular modems are there. Now also we having high speed modems. We can get it here. Previous concepts. Just I remind your people. And because it is explaining here. Previously we having GPRS method, very old one. Now edge, 3G, 4G, like that it is growth is coming here. That only it is explaining here. If IPv6 is used with this generation, it must be tunneled over the IP, because sometimes these all the generations we don't have at that time IPv6. We are using IPv4 only. If you want to use now IPv6 with this same technology, old technology, you have to use the method called as tunneling, because tunneling can convert IPv4 to V6 as well as changing back also V6 to V4 also. In the 4G LTE long term evaluation, 4G it will support both. The simple thing is 4G will support IPv4 and V6. Next is serial communication. Serial communication here it is a little bit should understand. Here serial communication mainly we are thinking about the legacy devices. What is legacy devices? Legacy devices is outdated devices, right? That is a very important thing, is outdated devices. Why outdated devices? Already we took some similar examples previously also. For example, I took a machine having 10 crore rupees. I took on 1980s. Now it is 2020, right? Now that particular device, I have to work automatically with the help of Internet of Things. Previously, it was 1980s already, you know, Internet of Things was not there. Now it is in 2020. I want to make that particular complete machine should work as Internet of Things. That means without the help of human being, it have to work. And it is a what type of device? We will call it a legacy device, because it is outdated, very old one. Normally it is communicating with the help of serial NICs. What we can you know that in the CPU connection we will use some serial ports, like that serial lines we are going to use and communicate for communication. We are using the serial lines. Normally at that time we can use the protocol DNP3, Modbus, IPC, International Electrotechnical Commission. These are the protocols we are using at that time to communicate there. There maybe we are using the analog modem. It is local connection modem, which is there only. There only it will work, right? But here, what is our aim is, what we can do now is, that serial port, we have to connect it with a router, right? What we want, now we have to connect with the Internet of Things. Serial port are there. The serial port we have to be connected with the router, and we have to be communicated with the help of different protocols, and it can be worked. That is the meaning here. There we can go with the TCP or UDP to be communicated, and there we can use with the both IPv4 or V6. Both you can use. Here the thing here it is. What was the previous communication was there? It is using these are the protocol for communication. It is communication with the help of serial lines, and mostly in past we are using this particular modem, old analog modem. Now it is analog modems are very less because it is very slow. And instead of this, all the things what we are doing, we can use the new method like that serial lines. It is existing here because already serial port are there. That serial port we have to connect with some routers. What routers we can get it here, and we can communicate with that one with our new protocols we can use, or either it can be used by TCP communication or UDP. Already you know, one is reliable and one is unreliable. UDP is unreliable and TCP is reliable, and we can communicate with anything, and it can be used with the IPv4 or V6. And current implementation mainly it is looking on IPv4 and IPv6 adaptation layer. Now IPv6 adaptation layer, because you will understand very clearly in the next slides, I will show you next one diagram is there. See, and this is the adaption layer where it will come in between network layer and data link layer. In other terms, if I am saying this physical layer and data link layer, what are the data it is generating, physical layer, you already know that it can be wired connection or wireless. If it is wired, wire, everything will come under the physical layer. Wireless means its link is going to come wireless. And data link layer means it is 802.14.4G or 15. It is personal area network. These are the communication protocols will come here. And communicating with this one with the IP, because two forms of IP we have. Either it can be IPv4 or T6. For communication efficiently, we are using this adaptation layer. That adaptation layer only we are going to discuss now. See that adaptation layer, IPv6 adaptation layer. Why this adaptation layer? Because physical to data link layer for recently standardized for IoT protocol support only IPv4. Because now maybe sometimes IPv6, maybe IPv4. That's why physical and data link layer already shown. Physical layer, data link layer, in between adaptation layer. Next is IP. Already I've shown that particular diagram. That physical and data link layer have to be support for the IPv6, because recently we are only concentrating on the IPv6 only. But in the later, in the previous some of the versions of some of the protocol, both it is going to support. Here some of the protocol it is given IEEE 802.15.4. It is already, you know, that wireless personal area network PAN and 1901.2 here, and International Telecom Union G9903 narrow band fiber line communication. These all the things are only having a IPv6 adaption layer. These all the things are supporting the IPv6. That is the meaning here. And IPv6 adaption must be communicated over IPv6 adaption. If you are implementing it, must communicate over IPv6 network only, right? IPv6 adaption, if you are implementing, it should satisfy in, or it should communicate with the IPv6. I hope it's clear with all the ideas of the second topic. This is our third topic, optimizing IP for IoT. It is not the fourth topic. It is our third topic. In the next lecture, we will see the third topic, right? Thank you. Thank you to all my students.